But some way, way, way more aggressive action on mortgages, and specifically on holding Wall Street accountable for using mortgages to blow up our economy, is happening not at the federal level, but at the state level, where New York State's progressive attorney general has thrown a wrench in the works of a planned settlement with big banks over some of their worst practices that led to the financial meltdown, instead pushing forward with a wide-ranging investigation into the big questions here, like what the banks did, what they knew, when they knew it, and how criminally liable they might be for their actions. Joining us now is Attorney General for the great state of New York, Eric Schneiderman. Mr. Attorney General, thank you for being here. I know you don't do a lot of interviews like this.
No, glad to be here, Rachel.
The big picture issue of housing and the continuing reverberations of the fiscal crash of 2008 are the biggest economic issues facing the country. There are also very obtuse partisan politics around these things. Do you think that Democrats have done well in responding to the mortgage crisis and the misbehavior of the banks?
Well, I think we've done some things. I think the president's move this week was a good step. I'm a prosecutor, and I took office in January, and Bo Biden, who's the Attorney General of Delaware, and I just thought we really needed to dig in a little bit deeper. And we were doing an investigation into what caused the bubble and the crash in the housing market. And it's really not all that obtuse. I mean, there are a lot of folks who are trying to rewrite history and paint it like it was a volcano or an earthquake, and that now we can move on to the problem of paying too much to cops and teachers and firefighters. This was a man-made crisis. It was created by regulatory neglect and greed. And I assure you, without telling you anything about secrets of our investigation, we have not found a trace of evidence that a cop, firefighter, teacher, or sanitation worker contributed to blowing up the American economy. So we're digging in, and we think we can do more. We think we're going to be able to obtain real, meaningful relief. There's 11 million Americans whose homes are underwater, not just in Arizona, but all across the country. We think we have to hold accountable the people who caused this disaster. And just as important, as I say, we got to get this out in the open so they can't rewrite history. I mean, Mr. Romney's comments, we should just let things hit bottom. This is the same sort of deregulatory mania that they were dishing out in 2005 and 2006. That didn't work so well for the economy.
Did this catastrophe happen because, as far as what you have been able to determine so far, because deregulation proceeded to a part where the banks, to a point where banks could act legally in a way that was nevertheless dramatically fiscally irresponsible? Or are we looking at a case of potential illegal behavior, behavior that was against the law despite the fact that they had been so deregulated?
Well, that's why you have an investigation. There may well have been a combination of the two. There's no question that they dismantled a lot of the safety mechanisms that have protected our markets for a long time. But, you know, we're also looking at the conduct of individual institutions and individuals to see if there were misrepresentations made, to see if there was any fraud committed, to see if criminal acts were also a part of this. And that's what Bo and I are looking at, and we're determined to follow it through until we can get that relief that the homeowners need and hold accountable the people who caused this.
That issue of holding people accountable is a guttural instinct in American politics right now, particularly because we know that the fiscal crisis was a man-made crisis. We know that this was something that people did the wrong thing and thereby hurt the entire country. And the country is still paying, but nobody has paid for what they did. That's just a base raw feeling that's driving the Occupy Wall Street protests right now. But I think it's also driving a lot of anger in the country, left, right, and center. You and Bo Biden have some jurisdictional opportunities here because of where institutions are incorporated that had a lot to do with these problems. Is there more that could be done at the federal level right now, starting now in 2011, that hasn't been done? Are there demands that should be made both of the administration and the Congress in terms of ways they can hold Wall Street accountable?
Well, it's challenging for the president because the Republicans in Congress have essentially openly declared they'll do things that they know hurt the American people just to prevent him from getting a win. But as you say, we do have jurisdiction because the mortgage-backed securities that brought down the country were all issued out of New York Trust or Delaware Trust. We're pursuing it, and you're absolutely right. A lot of folks look at Occupy Wall Street and the other occupations and think that they're fringe characters. I hear the same sense that we don't have one set of rules for everyone anymore, that people are not held accountable for misconduct. From every average American you run into, anywhere else, in a community hall meeting, in a diner all over New York State, I'm sure all over America. There is a sense that equal justice under law is no longer the rule for this country, and we got to get that back. I mean, as much as the economic damage is terrible, for Americans to lose the sense that this is a country where law governs and you're not above the law and you're not below the law, I mean, you know, the law applies to everyone. The sense of accountability is one of the key motivators for our investigation, and there are other AGs who are coming our way. I think there are actually going to be quite a few investigations before this is over.
As New York State's Attorney General, am I right that your office is quite near the Lower Manhattan Occupy Wall Street encampment?
It is, right across the park.
When you look, from what I hear you saying right now, my sense is that when you look at those folks out there protesting every day, you have some sympathy for what they're doing.
I see them as a part of they're the tip of a much bigger iceberg. I spend a lot of time traveling around the state. I have 13 regional offices, and I assure you that if anyone who thinks the American people have gotten over their anger at the bubble and the crash, over their sense of betrayal, that the fundamental American idea of equal justice under law has, you know, really been let go by the wayside, they're wrong. People are mad, and people want, not because they're hostile or vicious, they just want to know there's one set of rules for everyone. And I don't hear that much different in most of the Occupy Wall Street folks from what I hear everywhere else in the state as I travel around.